Before we get into the video, make sure you're subscribed and you turn on notifications, and be sure to smash that like button. Hey guys, Yoshi Bros 1389 here, and in today's video, we are going to be talking about this man, Takashi Iizuka. So, Iizuka has been with Sonic for a very, very long time, dating back to Sonic 3. So, he's got a long history with the Hedgehog, but recently, the guy's been getting a lot of hate. So in this video, we are going to have a discussion on Takashi Iizuka and find out why I think he gets hate from Sonic fans. What's your thoughts on Iizuka? Tell me in the comments and be sure to like the video. Before I get into why I think people hate the guy, let's just talk about him. So like I said, he's been with Sonic since Sonic 3 all the way back in 1993. Fast forward to current times, he's the head of Sonic Team. I'm pretty sure, yeah, he's the head, and I think he also might be the director of most of the games, but I definitely know he's the head of Sonic Team. And without him, we probably wouldn't have Sonic Mania. He was a big reason why that game came to light. He was a big reason why Sonic Mania was possible. And some might not know this, but he was a big, big contributor to Sonic Adventure, like the story. I don't know if he was that much of Sonic Adventure 2, but I also know he worked on Sonic Heroes as well. So, he's got a long history with Sonic, and he's made a lot of good decisions, like Sonic Adventure, Sonic Adventure 2, Sonic Heroes. He was even a level designer for Sonic Heroes. And without him, we might have not even ever gotten Sonic Mania. But now, he gets a lot of hate. Like, he's done a lot of good in the past, and even, like, recently, 2017 Sonic Mania, but I think his cons outweigh the pros. So, why does this guy get so much hate now? Well, recently, ever since probably 2011, what has been Sonic's big sin? It's been nostalgia. Sonic Generations, I can give that game a pass. It's literally, the whole premise of that game is nostalgia, going back to old Sonic stages. I can give that game a pass. Then you got Sonic Lost World. I don't know, trying to be classic Sonic? Like, almost everything in that game is classic Sonic related. Windy Hill, don't even call it that, it's literally Green Hill with some windmills, alright? Sonic Forces, and even Sonic Mania, that's really nostalgia, like, basically Sonic Generations, but 2D platformer. Got some new levels. Really good game, but heavy, heavy use of nostalgia. And then Sonic Forces. Classic Sonic again. Why? Why? Green Hill, stuff like that. Why? What's with this guy in just nostalgia? Like Green Hill Zone. We've seen it for the millionth time. It was cool in Sonic Generations. Not that cool anymore, alright, Takashi? Like, and also Chemical Plant. Weird they brought that back in Sonic Forces, but you know how many times Green Hill Zone was in Sonic Forces? I don't, but I know it's probably over 3 times it was in there. He also seems to just love classic Sonic, like I was talking about with Sonic Lost World. All the classic Sonic imagery and classic Sonic references. Like, Windy Hill Zone, Green Hill Zone, capsules, item box. Well, the item boxes look like the modern ones, not gonna lie, but capsules, Windy Hill Zone. Like, almost everything in Sonic Lost World is very classic Sonic pandering. Then, you know, Sonic Mania. A lot of classic Sonic. Sonic Forces. A lot of classic Sonic. So, in recent years, modern Sonic fans have just been just feeling like they're just being pushed out of existence for classic Sonic fans, because that's all we seem to be getting. Hopefully, with the next game, that's going to be different, but I don't know. Another reason why I think he might get some hate is because he, in a lot of his interviews, he gives a lot of stupid retcons. Like, when asked, why is the moon not destroyed in future Sonic games, in other Sonic games after Sonic Adventure 2, he says the moon is facing the other way. That's very stupid. He's asked about the human world and Sonic world. He says the human world and Sonic worlds are separate, but sometimes cross paths. Like, that doesn't really make any sense. So, he just kind of says a lot of dumb stuff. Or if he says something in a later interview, he might just backpedal. and say, oh, well, yeah, you know, I didn't mean that. And this is a sin in Sonic Forces and Sonic Lost World. He bring him back the Wisp. I'm pretty sure in an interview, he said he wanted to make the Wisp basically a core part of the Sonic franchise going forward after Sonic Colors. Did he say that because Sonic Colors was well received? Or did he genuinely just like the Wisp? Who knows? But it seems like a majority of Sonic fans just do not want the Wisp to be there anymore. Nobody likes them. And maybe you do like them, but it makes no sense why they're back. Literally in Sonic Colors they were shown to go away forever, and then boom, Sonic Lost World, they're just there without any explanation. Same with Sonic Forces, they're just there. Like, it makes no sense. And also, like, he just makes a lot of odd decisions. Like I said, classic Sonic nostalgia, bringing back the Wisps. Heck, I wouldn't throw it too far to say that he's the reason that Zaphok keeps coming back. I don't know. But he just makes so many odd and silly decisions with the Sonic franchise. It just boggles my mind. I can see why people hate him. So with all these reasons, what's my opinion on him? My opinion is, like, I don't even know how to put my finger on it, but I don't really know how I feel about Takashi Iizuka. I am very tired of him bringing Green Hill Zone back, bringing the Wisp Zaphok, stuff like that. But at the end of the day, is it really his fault? I mean, maybe it is. He is the head of Sonic Team, after all. He's probably calling the shots when it comes to stuff like this. So, overall, my opinion on him is he could do better. Let's just keep it at that. I think he could do a lot better. So, what is your opinion on Iizuka? Do you love him? Or do you hate him? I want to hear what you have to say in the comments. Also, here's a fun fact that you may or may not know about him, because I sure didn't. Did you know that Iizuka wrote the story for Shadow the Hedgehog? I thought that was pretty surprising. Anyways, if you enjoyed the video, consider subscribing, like the video, and please, please, please turn on notifications. I hope you had a great day. Alright, see ya!